Are you gonna see that comedy show later?
Yeah, of course.
I've never been to see a comedy show that's spoken in a different language, so I have pretty high expectations for this one. Same here, but I bet he could pull off the comedy pretty well.
Hola, hola, everyone.
Well, he's speaking pretty lively. It looks like he could be funny.
Okay, everyone. ¿Qué hace el pez perezoso?
¿Qué?
Nada.
That was pretty funny. I hope he does more. That's all for tonight. Gracias, amigos.
All right, so now that I'm gonna talk seriously,
I'm gonna put on this mic so you can hear me better. So today's subject we're learning is adjectives, or I guess relearning. Adjectives are things that describe nouns, which is something we all know, but we're just gonna go over some rules of adjectives in Espanol today because they're very, well, not very different, but they're pretty different from English. And so, examples of some adjectives would be atlético, artístico, baja, vieja, pelo castaño. And so, there's all these different ways to describe things, but the rules that we use in adjectives compared to English and Espanol are very different. So, let's go over some of them. So, as an example for all of these, I'll be using the joke sentence I said in the beginning. ¿Qué hace el pez perezoso? So, in this sentence, we're basically saying, what does the lazy fish do? And then the joke is nada, because that sounds like swim, the verb, which is nadar, but conjugated for it. So it could be nada, or nada could also sound like nothing because it's a lazy fish. Haha, very, 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 very funny. So, what is our adjective in this sentence? Well, it would be perezoso. And perezoso describes el pez, which is the fish. And now here comes our first rule, that adjectives are usually after the noun when you're speaking in Espanol, which is different in English because usually adjectives are before the noun if you're just using it normally. So if you want to say the lazy fish, you would say el pez perezoso instead of el perezoso pez. Our second rule is that the adjective should match the form of the noun. So if the noun is plural, then the adjective should also be plural. If the noun is singular, then the adjective should also be singular. In our joke sentence, pez was singular, so we used a singular version of the noun, which is perezoso. But if we were to use a plural version, like peces, or multiple fish, then we would use a plural version of the noun, or perezosos. And our final rule is that the adjective's gender should match the noun's gender. So in el pez perezoso, our noun was masculine, as indicated by el, because that is the form of the that precedes any masculine word. If we were to make it a feminine noun, like la vaca for cow, then it would be la vaca perezosa, which means the lazy cow. And if you think you got all of that, I have a review game for vocabulary down in the description or in the Google document if you want. As you can see, I've already made a template. So I have this template right now for a Spanish review game. And if you want to play it, it's just for vocabulary. Adjectives in Spanish. So if you want to play it, it'll be down in the description and stuff. Anyways, gracias for watching and hasta luego.